Hello, this is Connie Belden, and we're going to go ahead and move forward looking at this same worksheet and talk about the financial statements. After you prepare the worksheet, that can help you then in preparation of the financial statements. Now, there's actually no change in the income statement or the statement of stockholders' equity from what you learned in Chapter 1. The only change will be is where you get the numbers from. So let's take a look at the income statement. If we go back to our completed worksheet, our numbers in blue here represent our revenues and our expenses. We don't want to take the numbers from before the adjustments because the expense numbers and the revenue numbers are different. So for example, rent revenue $29,600, utilities expense $1,000, etc. So I take these numbers in my blue area. And you'll notice that I use those and I prepared the income statement. I added the expenses, I subtracted, I get the same net income that showed up on my worksheet. For the statement of stockholders' equity, some of this depends on if that amount represented any additional investment. So if I go back to my worksheet, you'll notice that common stock has a balance of $20,000. Now, it needs to note somewhere if some of that $20,000 included an additional investment during the year. If it did, that needs to be subtracted out. In this case, let's assume that there was an additional $2,000 issued in common stock. There was additional investment then in our company of $2,000 from additional common stock that we issue. So therefore, if we subtract, the beginning balance was 18, we issued two for a total of 20,000. As far as retained earnings go, let's go back here. The retained earnings of 10,000 will represent our beginning retained earnings. So going back, I'll start with 2,000. I'll add my net income. If you go back to the worksheet, you'll notice that dividends are 2,000. So those are subtracted out. So your ending retained earnings is 32,400. And you would just complete the total column. So nothing different as far as how we put it together. Now for the balance sheet. Again, for the balance sheet, we want to take the numbers after adjustment. So the numbers from our balance sheet for our balance sheet will be these numbers in green. So for example, accounts receivable would be 8,600, not 8,000. So we'll use these numbers in green to prepare the balance sheet. So once you have those numbers, there are some expansions to the balance sheet over what we did in Chapter 1. We talked a little bit about this in Chapter 3. First of all, we're going to divide up by current assets and by property, plant, and equipment. Okay, current assets will be those assets that are used up or generally changed within a year's period of time. You'll list those amounts in the middle column, total your current assets in the right column. So use this as a guideline for format. Property, plant, and equipment, sometimes known as fixed assets, are for those that we're going to hang on to for longer than a year, such as land, equipment, building. We talked about in Chapter 3 a little bit that you list the asset followed by its accumulated depreciation. So I have equipment followed by its accumulated depreciation, auto followed by its accumulated depreciation. If you go back to the worksheet, notice I have that right here as well. So I have my auto of 6,000, accumulated depreciation 2,700. Or sorry, that was equipment 6,000, accumulated depreciation 2,700. Auto 5,000, accumulated depreciation 1,000. So don't combine that accumulated depreciation. It's listed separately for each asset. Now remember, we talked about in the last chapter, you have to calculate book value. So you list the cost and accumulated depreciation here on the left. Take the cost minus, so 6,000 minus 2,700 gives me 3,300, don't add, subtract, for the book value. 5,000 minus 1,000 gives me 4,000 for the book value of auto. Don't forget to show your book value in the middle column. 3,300 plus 4,000 gives me 7,300 for property, plant, and equipment. Add it to your current assets, and you get total assets of 63,900. So we just expanded it a little bit there. Otherwise, the rest of the balance sheet looks very similar. Okay, let's talk about then closing entries. There's some information on it in your chapter notes, so I suggest that you go and look at that. Closing entries are done to close out your temporary accounts. Temporary accounts would be your revenue accounts, your expense accounts, and dividends. Why? Because you want those accounts to start with zero balances at the beginning of the next period. When you earn a paycheck and you get paid, don't your earnings start over again with zero? If you pay your utility bill, doesn't that balance begin with zero? But then there are also permanent accounts, such as cash, where if you have a $100 balance at the end of the month, that's going to carry over to the beginning of the next month as $100. So our closing entries just want to close out our temporary accounts. So the first one we want to close out is our revenue and our expenses, and we close it out to retained earnings. Move that over a little bit because that got cut off. There we go. So what you do then is you're doing the opposite of what you're normally used to. Revenue accounts have a credit balance. So we'll close rent revenue account out for its balance of $29,600. Again, you can go to the income statement to get the balance. And then you can go to the income statement and you want to credit each one of the expense accounts because they have debit balances. You want to credit them for their balances because in that way it zeroes it out. Okay, and then the difference, which should be your net income, will be credited or increase your retained earnings. Then you close out dividends by decreasing retained earnings and crediting dividends because, again, dividends have a debit balance in them. So by crediting it, that closes it out to zero. I suggest you look at the Chapter 4 instructor notes. There's a little more detail in that on closing entries, but I hope this helps you out with your Chapter 4 homework. Thank you very much.